what is the ultimate level of parenting? It's the Buba, the Zayda, it's the Eltern, isn't it? It's the Eltern.
What does that mean?
Well, you even know what that... Don't tell me that you don't know.
It sounds
know
like a Yiddish word of the week. I have no idea what it is.
It could be... We'll ask Meta, our guest, who is a grandmother and a grandparent.
Welcome to the show, Meta.
Thank you. You know the term, what Eltern means, don't you?
No, I don't.
Well, right. Take us to school, Barry. What does it mean?
Eltern means
the elders. It means the elders, but
and
really
it can refer to a parent, but it usually refers to a grandparent, you know, like the Eltern is.
And as we were discussing, there is no real word. We're looking for puberty or adolescence. But as Buba tells me, that you're kinned, which means child, that you're a kind from the minute you're born till the minute you die.
I was an idiot from the moment I
know
born,
that. So I that know.
And still
yes.
are, and we're proud of that.
Absolutely. Yeah. We've spoken now to a young parent and to a middle years parent, and now you're sort of faced the full gamut. What have you found the most rewarding aspect of parenting? I mean, looking back over the years, how do you view parenting? In terms of
successes and failures.
Successes and failures. Very blunt.
Well, you count your failures first, and then you have to think about what your successes are.
Well, you have three sons.
So it's the other way around, three
sons. And they're all middle-aged.
And they're all middle-aged
right,
now.
And you now have three grandchildren, which are what age?
That's right. 16, 14, 6 and 3.
Wow.
Okay, and you obviously have a hands-on relationship with
them.
Yes,
very much so, a hands-on relationship.
But it's different to when you had kids. So
very
I'm assuming
different,
it's
yes.
easier,
yes.
nicer.
Well, you have to have inordinate patience anyhow, whether it's children or grandchildren. Mm. But with grandchildren, you have more patience somehow because maybe it's because you can hand them
you
back
give them
after
that,
you yeah, spend that time.
Do you still treat your children in the same way you did when they were living under your roof as, you know, adolescents and as young children? I mean, does the way you relate to them change? You give them more space, or do you still telling them what to do and wiping their mouths and doing their hair and cutting up their food for them?
Yes, wouldn't that be nice? As adolescents, I suppose, maybe I was a little bit bossy, I suppose, telling them what to do. But as they grew up, there were more friends who actually have a very good relationship. It's sort of like like friendship and less of, I hope, I don't know whether they'll back me up on this.
Well,
but I hope, that it's...
We can only speak about one of your
not
sons.
Not so much telling them what to do. Maybe he's make suggestions.
We can ask him later what he thinks.
You.
Yes, because one of your sons, Russell, is involved on the show. He's one of our talents and involved behind the scenes. And he has nothing to say but glowing things about you.
Try to be understanding, that's all. Use quite a bit of psychology, maybe a little bit too much of it, you know. I'm like the home psychologist. Maybe it's not a good idea to do that.
You have three sons. Did you want daughters?
Oh, I think initially, yes. Mm. But there you go.
And then after the third son, did the disappointment set in?
No, not particularly, actually. I was quite happy when I had the third boy. It didn't matter. But the midwife
said,
what a shame. Oh. It's a boy.
What a shame. Is parenting different in England to Australia? And of course, your sons were born in England and now you live in Australia. Have you noticed some differences?
No, not really, because you're Jewish. And I think wherever you are, whether you're in England or America or Australia...
The guilt binds us all together.
The guilt, yes.
The guilt binds us.
It could be summed up in that where people always carry their baggage with them, we carry our cooking utensils with us wherever we go.
That's right.
Well, Meta, thank you very much for
thank
being
you
here
very
on
much.
The show.
It's been
we
a pleasure.
We really appreciate
thank
it. Yes, about 20 people. How much? Ah... I see. No, that's okay, I guess. Look, let me just check the numbers and I'll get back to you. Kimberly's out.
Tell us about the music. We're ending this show with a young lady. Her name is Alana Bruce. She's a very talented musician. I know her parents from way back when I was in a band with her father. Drew an enormous, the biggest crowd ever at Manchester Lane. Her album's called Degrees of Freedom, and which is related
which
to parenthood.
Relevant to adolescence and parenthood.
Totally related to parenthood, because I think it's all got to do with how much rope your parents give you.
Absolutely.
And she's been given heaps, and she still turned out to be brilliant.
That's fine.
Just check this music out.
Yeah.
Can I cream and cry or divide? your streets.
Hi, Mum. Yes, yes, yes. We've organised everything. We're having a family dinner at our house. Yeah. Just us. Yeah, like you wanted. Oh, Mum, do you think you can bring a cake?